Hi, welcome back. In my previous video tutorials, we have seen how to connect to MySQL database using JDBC, how to insert a data into MySQL database using JDBC, how to retrieve a data, how to update and delete a data with MySQL database. So far we have used JDBC statement interface to perform these operations. Now in this video, we are going to learn how to use JDBC prepare statement to perform insert, select, update and delete operations with MySQL database. Alright, let's get started. So first we will see what is a prepared statement and how to create a prepared statement and how to set up parameter values and how to execute a prepared statement and how to process the result. Alright, let's have a look into what is a prepared statement. A prepared statement is simply a prepared compile SQL statement. Prepared statement has following benefits. They make it easy to set SQL parameters, which will replace the placeholder values. They prevent against SQL dependency injection attacks, and they also make improve application. Alright, and it provides a better performance since the SQL statement is free compiled. Alright, so before we get started, there are some preparation work needs to take place. So first you need to make sure that you have installed MySQL database in your machine. If not, you can just check out the official website and you can download and install it. And also you need to download a MySQL JDBC driver, which we use to connect to the MySQL database. And here you can see it's a users table. We are going to use a users table with ID, name, email, country, password as a column names, and we perform insert, select, update and delete operations on this users table using JDBC prepare statement interface. Alright, so let's have a look into the development steps. So I really like this slide because it outlines what we need to do. So first we create a Java project in Eclipse IDE. We add the JDBC driver, we get a connection with the MySQL database, and we create a prepare statement object using connection object. We set the parameters for placeholders and we execute the SQL query, and finally we process the result set. So these are the development steps we need to apply on all the insert, select, update and delete operations. So first we will see how to insert a data using JDBC prepare statements. So notice here I have already created a database. The database name is JDBC_demo. So this database I was created in my previous video tutorials, and I'm going to use the same database. So here I have also created a users table in a database. So I'm going to use this users table in order to insert a data. Alright, so this is the SQL statement that we are going to use in order to insert a data into users table. Alright, let us see some coding stuff in action. So here you can see this is the class and it has a main method and it's an entry pointer for our Java program. And here I have created object of this class itself and I am calling insert record method. And notice here we need to first establish a connection with the MySQL database using get connection method, and we need to pass a JDBC URL, a username and password in order to establish a connection with the MySQL database. Once we got a connection object, then we can create a prepare statement object. So we need to call a prepare statement method, and we need to pass insert SQL statement here. This is the insert SQL statement, and here notice here this is a question mark. It means that these are the placeholder, so we need to insert our values into this placeholder dynamically. So next step is setting a placeholder values. Alright, so these are the standard fundamental steps you need to remember whenever you use JDBC in your project. Alright, once we set up the placeholder values, then we execute the prepare statement using execute update method. Alright, so execute update method will return integer value. Alright, and we can also print to the console here. Just sys out and just pass this result type here. So remember, the first step is you need to establish a connection with the MySQL database, then you need to create a prepare statement, and you need to set the values, and you need to execute. Alright, so here you can see I have handled the exception. So if there are any exception at try block, then you can caught that exception and you can print like this. All right. So this is the standard way you can print all the exception details. That's cool, right? So only you need to remember these steps, like get a database connection, create a prepared statement object using connection object, set the placeholder values and execute the prepared statement. Let's go ahead and let's run this application now. So notice here is an important tip I am going to provide you here. So this is the statement and this is the prepared statement. So notice here how the values are get replaced by the placeholder. So this is the SQL statement. It has question mark, but if you can see here, the question mark is replaced by values because I have printed this prepared statement object to the console by using sysout statement. That's why I can able to see the placeholder values are replaced. Alright, so this is how you can debug like what are the parameter you are passing to the prepared statement. So notice here in a MySQL workbench, I have just fired a select query and I can able to get a record in the users table. So this is how we insert a record into a database using JDBC prepared statement. Now let's have a look into how to retrieve a data from the users table using JDBC prepared statement. All right, so we retrieve the same record that we have inserted in previous example. So notice here the similar steps we are going to follow. You first get a connection with the MySQL database using JDBC URL and password here, and once we get a connection object, then we can create a prepared statement object using connection object here, and we need to pass a query here. So in our case, this we need to pass a select query, and once we get a prepared statement, then we can set the placeholder value and then we can execute the query. And in this case we are retrieving the data, so we need to iterate over a result set and we need to print a data to the console. So pretty simple steps we need to follow. So notice here where I have also handled the exception here and I have printed all the exception detail to the console. So this is the standard way you can also log the exception details to the console. So let's run the application now. So notice here I have printed a prepared statement object to the console here, and notice here the placeholder value is replaced by id equal to 1, right? And I have printed a row to the console. This is how we retrieve our data from the MySQL database table using JDBC prepared statements. Now let's have a look into how to update our data using JDBC prepared statements. Look at here, this is the sample program that I have written, and this is a main method which is the entry point of our program. And similar steps, like we need to first establish a connection with the MySQL database using JDBC URL and username and password. And then once we get a connection object, then we can create a prepared statement object using connection object. And we need to pass a update SQL query to the prepared statement method. And here we need to set a placeholder values here. So we need to replace the question mark, right? So question mark, it means that it's a placeholder. So we need to set up the placeholder values, right? And then we will execute the query. Pretty simple steps you need to follow. And here I have handled the exception, and I have printed exception details to the console. It's pretty simple. Similar steps you need to follow to perform different operations using JDBC. All right, let's notice here the name is Tony now, and I want to update name with Ram. All right, so let's go ahead and let's run this program and let's see. Notice here this is a prepared statement and the placeholder value is replaced here. All right, now let's look into these question mark values are replaced by Ram and 1, right? So notice here, let me fire a query. Yeah, here we go. The name is get updated, right? So earlier it was Tony, now it is updated with the Ram. That's cool. So look at here, this is the simple Java program where I have written a code to delete a record from the database. So this is the delete SQL statement, and notice here we are following the similar development steps, like we need to first establish a connection with the MySQL database using get connection method, and we need to pass a JDBC URL and password. Once we get a connection object, then we can create a prepare statement object using prepare statement object using connection object, and here we need to set up a placeholder values, and then we execute the method prepare statement using execute update method. Perfect. It's pretty simple. Similar steps we need to follow. Just run this program and let's see the output. Yeah, here we go. So now the record is deleted from the database. Let's verify. Let's open the MySQL workbench and let's verify. Yeah, here we go. The record is successfully deleted from the database. So this is how typically we perform, you know, different database operations, like how to retrieve, how to update, insert, delete. All right. So I have also created a write-up tutorial on this, topic. So let me show you the write-up tutorial that I have written, and you can get a source code of this video tutorial from this write-up tutorial. All right. Let me switch to the browser and let me show you the write-up tutorial. Yeah, here we go. So same explanation you can find on this write-up tutorial. All right, and you can also get a user DDL script, and you can also get a source code of how to insert a record, and you can get a source code here. And you can get a source code of updating a record into a database, and you can get a source code for how to retrieve a record from the database, and you can get a source code how to delete a record from the database. All right, this is how typically we perform different database operations using JDBC prepare statements. All right, thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.